What's up, guys? It is Jay Beebs here, and welcome to another episode of the All Quarterback Fantasy Draft. Now, as you know, the players you see in front of you, Jay Beebs, these aren't quarterbacks, these aren't your players. That's correct, because this is the Bengals team, who we are about to face in the AFC wildcard. As you can see, they have a very good team. However, Jared Goff is their quarterback. So that's the only chance we have of potentially winning this game. This is the biggest game that we've ever played. So I'm actually going to back out of this real quick, because I hope with the XP, I hope someone is available for an upgrade. Now, okay, Chad Kelly is eligible for an upgrade. Maybe this way he'll actually be able to catch the ball when it's thrown to him. I think one or two other players should be able to. Yep. Jalen Hurts is eligible for an upgrade. I am so nervous right now, because I do not want this season to end up being a waste and us not to beat our division rivals in the playoffs, which is so annoying because there's no way that this team is a 7-seed team. I mean, they beat the 2nd seed. Oh, I am so nervous right now. But as they say in showbiz, the show must go on. All right, let's talk to a couple people real quick. What are their strengths? I already know their strength. Yes, they're a beast of a team. All right, they're missing a running back. That doesn't matter. So our defense can't stop anybody. All right, who's it? Bryce Perkins. Matt, talking about Matt Barkley? I mean, more obvious for the offense. That's amazing. Alright, Whoa, this is a big, big game, and I don't want to do it, but we have to. So, for those of you who don't know how the series works, go back on my channel and watch the rest of it, because this is best series and best videos I've ever made on this channel. So I went through, I drafted 53 quarterbacks, and I moved their positions around. For example, Taysom Hill is at safety. Tristan Sorley is at linebacker. Sam Darnold at linebacker. Tom Brady is our quarterback. Russell Wilson's in at corner. Taysom Hill's in at safety. Ben Roethlisberger is our kicker. Let's get into the game. Alright, Big Ben's going to get us underway. He kicks it off. Alright, tackled him. Alright. We're going to have a tough time stopping this offense, because Goff has been playing well. They also have Juju Smith-Schuster. Thankfully, Philip Lindsay is actually out injured, as we saw a little bit before this game started. So that does give us some hope to potentially have a chance to stop this team. I'm pretty sure they have McKissick as their backup. He is still a very good runner, as shown by that. Oh, McKinnon.
Jerick McKinnon, the ball carrier. Second and three. He's brought down at the 42-yard line. A 7-yard pickup brings up second and three.
I'm so nervous,
man.
Good job there, McSorley. Third and two. What are they lining up? They're lining up in a shotgun formation. We're actually going to hit him with a nickel look. We're going nickel Tampa 2. Justin hopes that it's a quick throw. We can hopefully jar the ball loose after they throw it. Alright, the throw. Alright. It's unfortunate. And there's single back, so we're going to go 4-3. We'll go 4-3 cover 2 sink. So again, I don't think the Bengals really throw it deep all that much. that Darnold or Minshew?
Jerick McKinnon, the ball carrier. 2 yards on the He's carry across midfield to the 49-yard line. Nice 2 yards on the pickup.
All right, we'll go another team, too. All right, let's mention they made the tackle last play. Interception. Run, Trubisky. Run. Don't let Devontae Parker hit you. Let's go. Let's go. Mitch Trubisky with a pick six in the NFL playoffs. If that ever happens in real life, I will pay $1 million to somebody. Mitchell Trubisky. The quarterback that was taken before Deshaun Watson and Patrick Mahomes. The man who will always and forever and will always be known as that guy. Just got a pick six in the AFC Divisional Round for a touchdown. A pick six. Not even just a regular interception. A pick six. Oh, wow. Wow. Good tackle there. Come on, boys. We need this momentum swing. If we can, we need this momentum. We're going to try not to get away from what got us here, and that was the cover. That was the 3-4 blitzing. We used it pretty much all regular season. I switched playbooks entering week 16, trying something new. All right, good job. Good tackle there by Russell Wilson. I think we got to switch to that four-man rush, though. I think we got to go that four-man rush. I mean, it just got us a pick six. Made Goff throw it, an ill-advised throw. It's a draw, it's a run. At least the nice thing is we got a touchdown first. Usually these games end up being back and forth. And just with us getting the ball at half, we essentially have the comparative advantage. Ooh, that was a good run. Oh, yeah, they also have Larry Fitzgerald. I believe that's who it is. That's that player. So they have Juju Smith-Schuster, Larry Fitzgerald, Devontae Parker, Jared Goff. They had Philip Lindsay, but he's out injured right now. So yeah, this is a very well-built team. Which makes it that much harder. Oh, you're seriously going to let Juszczyk run it in for a touchdown? On a fullback dive, we just let them score a touchdown. Really? I don't mind that we got scored on. I don't mind that they rushed for us. But a fullback dive? Kyle Juicy Juice? Ugh. Man, I hate the playoffs. It's so tense. Especially with this experiment we're doing. This is rough. Alright, Flowers is going to return it here. Get that. Give me that block. Give me that block. 26? Yep. Alright, now the offense is going to step onto the field. Alright, yep, Tom Brady. He's only been our quarterback for 6 or 7 weeks. And he didn't play last week. Gave him the rest. So he essentially had... It's been 3 weeks since he last played. It's okay, Tom. It's okay. Just, we can get the rust off. Not the first play, though. We're going to run it here with Mariota. And there's already a holding penalty. Fantastic. That took one play for a hold on the right guard. One play. Oh, Paxton. Dude, you're a tight end. You should put us in a hole. You should put us in a giant hole right now. Why did you do that? Alright, we're going to look for Flowers underneath here. Yep. Get us back to the line of scrimmage. Alright. We're going to go with Trey look. See if they line up in. They're not going to cover two, it looks like, so... Etling might get open in behind those linebackers. I think we're going to hit Tommy Stevens. Aw. That's right, they have two. All right. All right, we'll spread it out. Spread it out here. Do a little play action here. We're reading that middle linebacker, see what he does. All right, he dropped off. So let's throw it up there. That was Flowers, all right. Really good throw there by Brady. I didn't know if that was actually going to work. See, the annoying thing is, that is Khalil Mack and Joey Bosa on opposite sides. So, unless they line up in a 3-4 or a 4-3, they're on opposite sides. So we can't really, you can't really pick, what side do we want to attack? We can't really. Ironically, we have to run it up the middle. Which is something we really struggled with all season long. I don't know why, but it's just always been something we haven't really been able to do that well. Alright, hopefully Perkins can... Oh yeah, I see where it's... Yep. Alright, I think Brady took a shot on that play. Alright, hopefully Stevens can just burn his man and go right in between these safeties here. Burn his man, right in between the safeties. Did he get in? He got in. First receiving touchdown in the playoffs for our best player. Brady's just got to do his job, deliver the ball. Stevens will force his way in there. All right, Big Ben's on the field to take the extra point, and we are now up 14-7. All right, that's good. Good job. Oh, this is so stressful. If you go back and you watch any of my other videos, usually talking a little bit more lighthearted for the series, but this is playoffs, baby. I invested there's a whole lot of time invested in this team. And worst thing I want is for us to go out in the divisional round. I would love to make it to the Super Bowl. Obviously, the goal is to win the Super Bowl, but I at least want to make it there. So I can say I took a team of quarterbacks to the Super Bowl. I don't think very many people can actually say that that's what they did. Because, not many people are as legendary as us. Not many people have a brilliant mind like mine. Where I was just sitting there brainstorming in the shower thinking of... Oh, what a sack. That Jacoby Brissett. Just standing there in the shower, thinking of ideas. What kind of content could I come up with? What would be a cool little interesting twist on something to do? Bam. Drafting 53 quarterbacks. And let me tell you, I plan on doing this for every single position group. And I'll be honest, I cannot wait for the offensive line and defensive lines. Because I cannot wait to see how funny all of that will be. Alright, Taysom Hill is going to actually have a chance to return a punt. It's probably his fourth return, where he's actually not had a defender right in his face the minute the ball arrives. Alright, so it's pretty obvious. This two running back set is actually working a little bit this game. We're going to look Flowers underneath. Just get him his yards after catch. Ooh. I was looking to go for a little bit of Braxton Miller against Virginia Tech spin there. That's okay, that didn't work. Alright, we're gonna try to hit him with a slip screen. They've been blitzing a little bit, actually. Alright, okay, we got blockers in front. Actually, a really good play. 8 yards. Yep, 2nd and 2. Good job there. Bring in Jordan Ta'amu, our power back, just pounded up the gut. So now they're in a 3-4, so Bosa and Mack are all on one side, so we can just simply avoid that. But if they're lined up in a dime or nickel look, that simply just doesn't work for us. It's pretty obvious that this team is we're pretty pass heavy. And that's because we don't really have an offensive line for running the ball. But we do have an amazing quarterback and some amazing wide receivers. Tommy Stevens, the receiver who just caught that ball, finished the season with 2,131 yards, I believe. And I'm going to be honest, we had a pocket mobility there from Brady, finding Quinton Flowers for the first. 8 for 9, 100 yards in touchdown. Beautiful stat line for Brady. But obviously, we pass every team. Our tight end, Perkins, who's actually not on the field right. Actually, he's on the left. Perkins, or the player on the field most to the left. He's our starting tight end. He finished the season with over 1,000 receiving yards. Etling, who just got the ball, he had over 900 yards. So we do spread the ball around a lot with this team. So it looks like they're in a overload blitz to the right, but we're going to run it at the overload blitz on the right. Just because you never know what can happen in those situations, you know? Sometimes it's a complete bluff, and Perkins over the top. That's what I'm looking for. Alright, that's not open. Worship Flowers. There we go. I mean, this is a pretty good Tom Brady offense. You know, first look is that big play. Second look, dump it underneath your athletic wide receiver or running back. Pick up the first. Alright, third and inches. I think we're in run territory here. Alright, so we're going to take Tom Brady out, put Streveler, the Wildcat, / backup, / superstar QB in, and we're going to run right at Bosa and Mac. We're going to send a message to Bosa and Mac that they are still good and we're not going to get a yard. Okay, I form, halfback lead. Flip a run away from Bosa and Mac this time. Touchdown. Jordan Damu with the rushing touchdown, baby. Let's go. So 20, pending the extra point, 21-14. With minute 21. Oh, that's right. They punted? Yeah, they punted. Oh, we have a chance to seal the game. We have a chance to win. If we can hold them to no points here, the game is over. If we can hold them to no points here, the game is over and we win. However, I mean, it's pretty obvious that this is a passing situation. However, our team struggles in these situations. Especially when they do have time and timeouts. So they can just throw their knees for a negative 2 yards there. And I will not mind because they went out of bounds off the clock. Honestly, we could get the ball back and score. Oh, the pressure. Alright, he's down. Yep. In bounds, they're going to go no huddle. Alright. Stop him short, call a timeout. And we should actually be getting the ball back. We're going to look to return. I don't actually think that we'll get a chance to return it. But you never know what can happen. I mean, the blocks are setting up pretty well right now. Alright, so we're on the 33. I don't know how strong Big Ben's leg is. But I do know that we can see exactly what defense they're running because of Tom Brady's Omaha. So they're running a cover one man. This is a very interesting play call. I'm going to assume at least one linebacker is blitzing. Oh, great. Don't let them score this. You're joking.
Touchdown, Cincinnati. It's a pick six for a Bengals TD. Zane Gonzalez lining up for the extra point.
Anyway. That's a
really?
Like to have
back and right in the lap of the defender from there. Just see if we can hurt somebody now. That is so annoying.
No!
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
I'm in disbelief.
Because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play.
The Steelers take over first and 10.
I don't understand.
At their own 25-yard line.
Tom Brady leads the offense out for their next possession. He's thrown the touchdown, but also an interception. As a quarterback, is that interception?
Cover one again. Amazing catch there by Stevens. As long as we score a touchdown here, I won't mind. Perkins. Etling caught that. Okay. I am choking and I do not like this. Alright, we're gonna look Stevens on the post route. Nope, Perkins underneath. Just get out of bounds. Alright. 20 seconds left on 22 with the time left. I can't believe I threw that pick. I mean, their pass rush is insane. Oh, come on, Perkins. Come on, Perkins. Inside the 5. To the 4. Alright. I think we try. This is something that worked for us very well all throughout the regular season. Struggle in this formation. You either can simply just throw it or you can run it in. And he'll simply just throw it to Perkins for the touchdown. Alright, so we made up for that touch, for that pick six. Assuming we can stop, keep them from scoring in 10 seconds, we should be up 2 scores at the half. However, we have given up 2 kick return touchdowns to this exact Bengals team. So we are going to try, essentially dare them to try and score again.
This one taken just inside the 10. He'll return up past the 30.
All right.
The Bengals take over first and 10.
Yeah, they're going to go Hail Mary, so we're going to go man up 3-deep. Guess pass, obviously.
From this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play.
Trying to just swat it down. All right, good. Heading into half, up 14. Offense is firing on all cylinders. Slight mishap with that pick six, but short-term memory. For you and out there, he threw a touchdown on the next drive. We don't care. We're getting more rushing yards than us, but we're dominating. We're almost 200 yards passing. All right, Sam Cook's gonna get the kick. All right. Take it to the 25 there.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
I think we're going to put Shukok on. All right, so they're in a 4-3.
They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff...
All right. 2 yards, not the greatest.
He was tackled at the 27-yard line. A gain of a yard. Brings up second and 9.
Now we're going to run it. Oh, no, we're audible to the QB power. If we can get Strebler to the edge. Yep, just like this. Solid 13 yards there.
That's good. We're up Pittsburgh Steeler.
Nice. All right, now they're going to hit Mariota with a draw. Nope. I'm going to pull back inside. Get Easton stick a carry after we chew a little bit more clock.
Well,
couple of yards there. Three. Yep. That's all we need. I'm going to hit him with the play action out of this. Hopefully Flowers is able to get... I think the middle linebacker is going to drop off, so I think he's actually going to be underneath these linebackers. I don't know what happened with Brady there. I don't know what the movement was there, but we look men. Alright, we're going to look Etling here. If Etling isn't open, we're going to look Stevens. He didn't quite get there. Fourth and three from 47. Could pin them deep. We could also go for it. This is the playoffs. I think we're going to be safe here. And Finley is just going to get a good punt here. Yep, to the 23. That's all you really get from Finley at punter. Alright, good tackle there by Hurts. Now we'll bring a little bit of a man blitz here. With the rush five on five. Alright, thankfully that missed. Alright, so now it's 3rd and 5. We're gonna go nickel look. Nickel Tampa 2. Actually, no, we're gonna go a nickel cover 2 man. Oh, fumble. Jeez. Just got lit up. Alright, we're gonna bring a safe. We're gonna bring Taysom Hill on the blitz. Cam Newton interception. Let's go. And we're back where we left off, essentially. Just move up a couple of yards. That's right, Cam. You tell me, the man. Alright, so... Actually, I'm just going to snap it and poop it through Perkins. First down right there. They brought the overload blitz. Had the right routes on the other side. And it left that linebacker to cover Perkins. And sometimes you can get away with that. Other times you can't. Right, we're going to try a little bit of a misdirection in the backfield here. Honestly, I'm down to just take as much time off the clock and kick a field goal. I'm in no rush here. No, I don't think anybody in our team should be that much in a rush. We have the ball. We are in control of the game. We are in control of the clock. We can control the outcome of this game. We got two picks. And I think, oh, you know, that's pretty good about the defense. We all understand how bad this defense is. I don't think we've ever had two turnovers in one game. So that's what, 3rd and 3 now? 3rd and 4. Well, you know what? It's been working all day long. We're 50% conversion rate. All right, no, we're gonna flip this play. Yeah, we're gonna run away from Bosa and Mac. Mariota, you missed your block. That was a touchdown if Mariota made the right block there. Alright, so now we're going to wind the clock all the way down. Just take the delay of game so that literally no time is wasted. Because 16 or 21 yarder, or 28 or 33, it's the same for Ben because you can easily hit this through. So now then they'll have like 7 minutes and 5 seconds-ish to score. A touchdown, and a field goal. Assuming that we don't score again. All right.
Now a field goal forthcoming for the Steelers. A 33-yarder from the left hash.
Kick is up, and it is good. All right, so now we are up 17 with minimal time left in the game. The entire stadium has our backs right now. Feeling good right now, boys. Let me tell you that. There we go. Do not let Kyle Juszczyk score on us again. I think we're at the point where we go prevent man up 3 deep. Just gets past, because if they want to run, they can run. And we're purely in the clock burning business right now. Good stop there. Now, where's the cover four drop? Yeah, you're not running it. And if you are, be my guest. And a good tackle there by Joe Webb. Just gonna keep going. Cover four drop.
Brings up second and three at the Steelers' 48-yard line. Tackling's been really good. And because of that, it's been
very, very hard for them to move the ball. Oh. Good breakup there by Trubisky. Now we're going to formation sub a little bit here. We're going to put Haskins there. Actually, no, we'll put Boyle there. We'll put Haskins. Alright, didn't have a chance to make all the subs I wanted. But that is, remind you, that is Alex Smith at our D tackle. Push him out of bounds. Didn't get a chance to make my subs. Because I want to put Haskins in for McSorley. I think, am I allowed to put, no I am not, and we'll put Tyree Jackson there. So we're trying a little bit of a different look here. We're going for bigger men on the line, quicker players out on the perimeter. There we go. Really just getting as many members of the secondary out on the field as possible. We're going to put Heineke there, which means I want to put Newton here. So yeah, there we go. So we got 8 members of the secondary out there right now. That's exactly what I want in this situation. We don't need to make these big, we're not looking for the big hits. We're looking for the time wasting. We're looking for the safe, clean tackles. No, I think I'm going to stick in my curated formation. Alright, let's get Joe Webb in there. Again, want these middle linebackers with a better play rec. Really just different rushers. Because depending on what Cam Newton's injury is, we might alternate between the two and just try to give, just hope the Bengals mess up at some point. Just give them a look they aren't expecting. And Drew Brees, I'm pretty sure, is playing in coverage right now. Alright, so we're up 11. 5:16 left. Honestly, that drive was just kind of trying to see, what are they going to throw? Muscle cramps will return soon. Alright. Because we're just trying to see, what are they going to try to do? Are they just going to look to go deep and just panic quickly? Or are they going to just try to slowly, methodically break us down like they just did? And I'm fully comfortable with that. I'm also fully comfortable just chewing clock this entire game. I don't think anybody on this team's in a rush to go anywhere. I'm going to look to hit Mario quickly out of the backfield. Look at that. Look at Mariota. He's a beast, let me tell you that. You're the best sacking team. They have no sacks today.
a pickup of six.
Grant, they have put pressure on us just about every single play. I'm going to wind the clock down. I don't think he got there. I think it's inches, I believe. Yep, 30 inches. Actually, might prefer that. I'm going to confuse him with a little bit of cross-back action in the backfield. Yep, there we go. That's what we've been looking for, Mariota. I mean, we're cruising at this point. They can't stop our run. They can't slow the clock down. Just gonna take advantage of that. We're getting these quick short rushes. They're winding the clock down. Like, you know, oh, chewing the clock, but you don't even understand. We're almost at the 2 minute warning. I mean, I think we're in a position to win it now. I think if we just rush for this next first down, game should be over. I mean, I think Tom Brady's just been handing it off this entire fourth quarter. Now, see, we're in four down territory, I think, as well. Yeah, we're in the 46. This is four down territory. Right, they're overload blitzing on the left. I picked the wrong hole there. But we're going for it. Yeah. We were conservative earlier in the game. Now we're being aggressive. First down, baby. We didn't jump. We just won the game. And just like that. We won. The game is over, baby. This team of all quarterbacks is advancing to the AFC Championship game. There's been ups and downs all season long. We were doing very well at points. We did very bad at points. We got away with some wins. We ended up losing games we should have won. But we can confidently say we are going to the AFC Championship game. We, as a team, could potentially make history. That just sealed the game. Marcus Mariota. Let me tell you, man. Not the player we've been looking for all game long. Hasn't been a big point of the offense this season. Hasn't really done much. But what he has done, he's delivered when we needed him to. 14 rushes for 70 yards, most of them coming on this drive. That's all we needed him to do. And we knocked the Bengals out of the playoffs. We'll give Mariota one last run. A little bit of a victory lap. Get those stats up a little bit. That's the game, baby. We are advancing the AFC Championship. I mean, this should boost the team's overall morale and just the fans' confidence in us. I mean, we won 13-3 in the regular season. We deserve to be here. Look at that. That is domination all across the board. That is a Super Bowl caliber team. Oh my. This is still just the beginning. You know? we're still just getting started. We still got the AFC Championship game. Don't know who we're facing yet. Hopefully we face the Patriots, because I think their team's not that good. Because I think they have Baker at QB. Or actually, I think we might want to face the Chargers. I don't know. But I do know is I want more coach XP, because I want to get our wide receivers to be better. All right, let's see who's got upgrades. Minshew's got an upgrade. That speed rusher up to a 30 overall. Nice. Finesse moves, tackle went up. Perkins has an upgrade, and I think that's it for the team, actually. Get that possession up. Look at all those. Look at all that. Yep, that's everyone. Wow. Alright, let's see the message from this team leader. Alright, I don't know which Matt they're talking about. They're talking about Matt Ryan or Matt Barkley. Alright, let's head to the conference championship. Let's see who we're going to end up facing. The Patriots. Okay. This is indirectly who I kind of asked we would be and hoped we would be facing. Alright, weekly rewards. Was it Brady? Trubisky. Alright, Baker played very well last game. Alright. See the message from the team leader. Super Bowl bound. Yep. So, their morale's up to like 80 now. It's gone up 80 in the last week. Tell me what they're best at. Alright, they're getting pass defense. So we're missing a defensive end, but that doesn't matter. Alright. So if you want to see this game, 3:05 p.m. at Heinz Field, the Pittsburgh Steelers, New England Patriots, and the AFC Championship game. That is going to be one of the biggest games I've ever played, this team's ever played. So if you want to see how that game goes, make sure that you subscribe to the channel, or just check back frequently, you know. If you don't want to subscribe, you don't want to get the notifications, you just want to watch the videos, I'm fine with that. It is JBeebs, signing off.